We're looking at 4.4, which is on spanning sets and linear independence. Now, if you haven't watched it already, go and watch this 3 blue 1 brown video. It's linear combinations, span, and basis vectors. It's a really good video, and it'll really, in my opinion, it does a great job of explaining this stuff in an intuitive way, but it doesn't do any, you know, it doesn't give you any problems to solve or examples, but it, I think it's very, very helpful in understanding this. And it's just barely, well, it's 10 minutes long, so it's well worth your time. But let's go ahead and look at linear combinations. This is a review, but this is closely related to what we're going to be doing today. So recall, a vector W is a linear combination of some other vectors. If there are scalars, so that you can write W as, you know, a scalar times U1 plus a scalar times U2 and so on. And let's do a couple of these examples. This says, is this vector a linear combination of these three? And the way to do that, of course, is to set this vector up as a linear combination of those. Now, you could write this out as 15. I'm actually going to do this slightly differently. I'm going to put this first. C1 times 4, 1, 3, 5. I'm going to be lazy and not write my commas in there. 2, 6, 0, negative 6. 4, 3, 2, 3. So we'd set this up as this is equal to 15, negative 6, 18, 36. But really, when you go to solve this, what you want to do is write this as a augmented matrix. So we get this for the C1 column. C2 column is going to be 2, 6, 0, negative 6. C3 column is going to be 4, 3, 2, 3. And then we get 15, negative 6, 18, 36. So what we've got to do is solve this system. And of course, the quickest way to do that is to type it into Octave or stick it in some other calculator. So let's see, we've got 4, 2, 4, 15. Then 1, 6, 3, negative 6. Then 3, 0, 2, 18. And then 5, negative 6. 3, 36. All right, so that should match my matrix I've got written there. I'm just going to double check it. Okay, now before we row reduce it, what are we looking for? It's asking, is this a linear combination? So to answer this question, really all we're asking is, does this system have a solution? So if we row reduce it, we get this. And this last line here tells us that there's no solution. So let's write this down. This gives us the augmented matrix. This line right here tells you there's no solution. What that means is there's no set of C1, C2, and C3. There's no values for those that make this a linear combination. And therefore, it's the answer is no, it's not. Example 102 says, is this matrix a linear combination of these two? So to set this up, what you would do is you'd say C1 times negative 2, 3, 4, 4, plus C2 times 2, 2, negative 6, negative 2, equals negative 11, 4, 27, 17. So we've got to solve this, and you could, in order to put this into an augmented matrix to solve it quickly, you could go through a lot of steps and write out an equation for this position, an equation for this position, and so on. And you'd wind up with four equations. But here's the quick way to do this. Eventually, we're going to put this into an augmented matrix to solve. So what you want to do is on each one of these matrices, you want to pick an order to go with. And what I'm going to do is what I just sort of outlined here. I'm going to use this first, and then this, then this, and then that. And as long as you're consistent with your order, it's fine. It doesn't matter really which order you pick. So this matrix is going to give me the line, or the column rather, negative 2, 3, 4, 4. This one is going to give me the column 2, 2, negative 6, negative 2. And the last one's going to give me negative 11, 4, 27, 17. And so now it's just a matter of row reducing this and seeing if we have a solution. One caveat here. Doing this on octave is no problem. Doing it on, I think, like a TI-89 is no problem. If you put this matrix into a TI-83 or 84 and probably some of the other older TIs, you're going to run into a problem. When you put this in and row reduce it, it's going to give you a dimension error. It's going to give you some kind of error and it won't do it. That's because of a bug in the calculator. The older TI calculators, let's see, I've got one somewhere around here, but here it is. These older TI calculators, if you try to get them to reproduce a matrix that is taller than it is wide, it doesn't like it. So the way around that is just to throw in sort of a dummy column over here, just of zeros, and then just ignore them, pretend they're not there. But octave has no such trouble. So let's stick this into octave. So we've got negative 2, 2, negative 11. 3, 2, 4. 4 minus 6, 27. 4 minus 2, 17. I always do a quick double check to make sure I typed it in correctly. And now let's row reduce this. Okay, it gives me some funny looking numbers there. It's not funny looking numbers, it's just decimals. So let's copy that down over here. It gives me 103.01, negative 2.5. And then two rows of nothing but zeros. So does this give me a solution? Yeah, it gives me a unique solution. So what this says is there's a unique solution. Well, is this matrix a linear combination of this? The answer to that is yes, because this gives us a unique solution. Actually, it's not the fact that it's unique, it's just the fact that it gives us a solution. It says C1, remember this top line here tells us C1 is 3, and C2 is negative 2.5. So if you wanted to, you could go back through there and test that. Multiply this matrix times 3, this one times negative 2.5, and it would work out to exactly that. All right, so that's it for this. Example 103 is asking us to mark these things as true or false. First one says, every vector in R2 is a linear combination of 0, 1, and 1, 0. Okay, to answer this, there is a way you could do it using a matrix, but these three problems, we can do them just using just some geometric reasoning. So let's look at this. The vectors 0, 1, and 1, 0. If we were to draw out the x and y axes, the vector 0, 1 is, that's going to be a vector going straight up. And 1, 0 is going to be a vector going straight over. We're going to see this pop up later. But if you look at these two, you can get anything you want by adding those two guys together, multiples of them together. If you want to get this point over here, all you have to do is add a few purples together. Basically, a better way to think of that is stretch the purple out until it's up to here, and then add the green onto it until it stretches over there. So is every vector in R2 a linear combination of those? Yes. Right. This was supposed to be a true or false question. So this is true. All right, the next one says every vector in R2 is a linear combination of 2, 2, and negative 1, negative 1. Let's do the same thing. So if I draw in 2, 2, and negative 1, 1, 2, 2 points up here. And negative 1, negative 1 points down here. Now, those two lie on the same line. So if you think about what you can get by taking linear combinations of these guys, all you're going to get is stuff that lies on this line here. So you can get anything on that line, but you can't get anything else. So is every vector a linear combination of those? No. So this is false. All right, what about this last one? Every vector in R2 is a linear combination of 0, 3, and 1, 1. Let's see, I'm going to do the same sort of thing here. 0, 3, that's going to be pointing up to the number 3 on the y-axis. And then 1, negative 1. Let's see, that goes over to 1 and down to negative 1, so that's going to be this vector here. Can we get anything in the plane by taking linear combinations of those guys? Sure, we can. If you wanted to get, say, this point right here, just as an example, what you do is you take this and you stretch it up until you get to a point where you could go down and hit this. The important thing there is they don't lie on the same line, and therefore you can get anything you want in the plane. This is leading up to this section down here on spanning sets. What we say is these two vectors, these span the plane. Or we'd say they span R2. These two vectors here, together they span R2. These two vectors, though, they don't span R2. And we'll look at the definition of spanning sets and more problems like this in the next video.